Let's talk about Stranger Things, the 80s-themed Netflix show created by the Duffer Brothers. It recently released its 4th season, and oh boy, is it great. It's kind of sad that season 5 will be the final season of the show, as I just recently became a fan of the show. In my opinion, the Duffer Brothers did a great job in this season, and I can't wait for season 5. But time to get to into the juicy stuff. The theories and predictions for season 5. Now that I have gotten over the absolute roller coaster of emotions that was season 4, I started thinking of the future of Stranger Things, specifically season 5. As we all know by now, season 5 will be the last season of Stranger Things. There's bound to be a lot of storylines and plots from the previous seasons that have to be wrapped up in the final season. This then leads to a lot of theories on how this plot could be finished, and that's where I come in to tell you every absurd theory that, who knows, might just come true in the final season. In this video, I'm going to tell you only the craziest of theories, like one being 11's dad, or Eddie still being alive, and a lot more absurd theories. The first theory is Vecna isn't the strongest. As was proven in season 5, Vecna is the Mind Flayer and creator of the Hive Mind, Adam, meaning he is the strongest, right? Well, not exactly. Dustin himself even said that Vecna is the 5-star general of the Mind Flayer, but what if he was partly right? What if Vecna is the 5-star general of an even stronger creature, cause I don't think they're gonna end Stranger Things with the same old bald dude from season 4. This theory was further proven in the scene where Will was showing Mike a painting of him and the gang fighting a dragon, which could be the big bad I'm referring to. And this theory was even further proven by the Vecna's bold statements, like, "You have already lost." He was about to die in this season 4 finale. Seems like a weird thing to say as you're about to die to a teenager, or is that just me? Okay, so time for another crazy theory. We were superpowers, and some of you might say, how can anyone with a haircut like that have superpowers? And to that I say, it's the 80s, and anything can happen in the 80s. I feel like I don't even have to explain this. They basically confirm it in season 4, like if magically being able to sense Vecna is still alive, Vecna is still alive, isn't superpowers, I don't know what is. Okay, cool. We were superpowers. Now let's move on. One is 11's dad. Well, one was definitely old enough to make a child before 11's birth. And Dr. Brenner, or Papa for short, is an absolute psychopath. He plays mind games with you and somehow gets Papa stuck in your head, cause this show can't just stop saying Papa and Papa and Papa, and it's such a weird word. And if this dude can get Papa stuck in your head, who knows what else he could do. Also, this would explain why one cared about 11 and wanted that. Cause why else would this random dude want to be with this random girl so much? Actually, time for the craziest and the most absurd theory of them all. Eddie is still alive. That one statement could bring back millions of fans who left the series for the one reason that Eddie was supposedly dead. Personally, I don't think anyone is dumb enough to kill such an amazing character. So I came up with a theory that this beloved character isn't dead. So let's gather some facts. We know that Eddie supposedly died in the Upside Down. We know that Vecna needs a new body, and we know that Vecna has easy access in and out of the Upside Down in anybody. Connect some dots together and boom, Eddie is still alive. Let me know of any other crazy theories you have down in the comments. Who knows, I might make it part 2 if this video is successful enough.